Meanwhile, the rain did not dampen the spirits of these demonstrators at downtown Kuala Lumpur. Tens of thousands of Malaysians turned out for 2 days of weekend rallies to demand Mr. Najib's removal. They shut down the city center in a carnival atmosphere of speeches, sing-alongs, and prayers. But it was former Malaysian Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad who stole the show when he made brief appearances at the rallies yesterday and today. The 90-year-old former leader apologized for his role in aiding Mr. Najib's rise to power. He accused Mr. Najib of abusing his power to stay in office and avoid charges. The current Prime Minister has come under fierce pressure following corruption allegations over his involvement in the 1MDB probe.
There is no more rule of law. The only way for the people to get back to the old system is for them to remove this Prime Minister. We must remove this Prime Minister. And to remove him, the people must show people's power.
Malaysia's Defense Minister Hishamuddin Hussein says Dr. Mahathir, quote, crossed the line with his presence at the Bersih rally. During his administration, Dr. Mahathir had stated that street protests should not be supported. Authorities have warned rally organizers and participants that they face legal action even after the rally's end. Police have declared the protest illegal, blocking the organizers' website and banning their official yellow t-shirt and logo. Malaysian politics expert Professor James Chin tells us about the significance of Dr. Mahathir's appearance at the rally.
I think Mahathir is trying to send two very clear messages. The first message is obviously for the Malaysian government, in particular the Najib administration, is sending the message that he is willing to work with everyone, including the opposition, to get rid of the Najib administration. So he's sending a signal to the opposition that he will support the vote of non-confidence. The second message he's sending is to the people protesting against Najib. He's showing the people that this appears to be the only way. As he said in the interview, all other avenues are shut down, and therefore, the only way for the people to send a signal to Najib is through street protests.
The Bersih 4.0 rally plans to disperse after 34 hours of protests, just as the nation ushers in its national day. Channel NewsAsia's Sumisha Naidu has more.
They spent the day occupying roads surrounding Dataran Merdeka in Kuala Lumpur, and many Bersih 4 protesters spent Saturday night on those same streets too.
Kita rasa seronok lah pasal ramai sangat yang tidur. Now my back is still from a little ham and I can't sleep all night. Too noisy, everything the same, loudly. But I think Malaysia people, all Malaysian can get work together is a good thing lah.
Organizers intend for the rally to continue all day Sunday with prayers, songs and speeches till right before midnight. That's ahead of Malaysia's National Day celebrations on Monday, August 31st. Spirits are high, but some Malay language papers have claimed the rally is an opposition-run failure with mostly Chinese participants. Some have also attributed the alleged lack of Malay presence to little support from Islamic Party PAS. Still, the protesters are unfazed by the critics.
No, I feel that because I was here from yesterday morning, I feel that, yes, beginning stages we can see about, you know, Chinese, but later on, after 3 weeks, Malays, the Indians coming in.
Not opposition, everybody's here.
Definitely no.
Some predict that former Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad's surprise visit to the rally site on Saturday will encourage more diverse participation on Sunday. And that was indeed the case for this 22-year-old student.
To have been inspired me so much to come today. That's why I come here, because I love this nation. I love nation. There are a lot of Chinese. We have also Malay here and also Indian here. So I think we are all Malaysian and we are already together here to support this nation to make a change.
Malaysia's current Prime Minister, however, is less impressed. One of of the rally's main goals is to get him to resign as Prime Minister after a high-profile corruption scandal over state investment fund 1MDB. But Mr. Najib has maintained his innocence, and he says protesters lack patriotism for holding the rally so close to the country's national day. Sumisha Naidu, Channel News Asia, Kuala Lumpur.